In the Laplacian eigenmap algorithm, one usually uses the generalized eigenvalue problem, and usually one doesn't have such a strong intuition for the generalized. It's much more intuitive to think about the ordinary eigenvalue equation. So therefore, it's interesting to know that one can actually switch back and forth. So if we consider, if we define vector D as the diagonal elements of our weighted degree matrix, and then we take the square root of that, or the inverse of the square root of that, and then we define the diagonal matrices, matrix versions of that, which is simply taking the square root of matrix D, or the inverse of the square root of matrix D. Then, by the way, if you take the product of two such matrices, it's the identity matrix, and if you take the product of two times D bar, it is D again. Yeah. If you have that, then one can show that the generalized eigenvalue problem turns into the ordinary eigenvalue problem. So maybe we can go through this here. So first we move LU to the right side. That gives rise to this one here. Then we introduce these identity matrices here, left and right to L. And also we write this D in this form with an identity matrix in between. So then we can move D bar outside of the equation, left and right. So then we have this one. And if you now define our matrix L hat and our vector U hat in this way, we get this equation. And then we can multiply with D bar inverse and get an ordinary differential eigenvalue equation. And we have to assume that D bar is invertible for that. So now we can use our intuition for this ordinary eigenvalue equation, and remember that we have this mapping that U bar is defined, U hat is defined as D by U, and then conversely U is defined as D underscore U hat, and that L hat is defined as D underscore L D underscore. For the example above, we find this one here, so we have to divide the rows and the columns by the square of the elements of the degree matrix. This is what these two matrices do from the left and to the right. And if we do that, we get this matrix, and we see that now the diagonal elements have the value of 1 by construction. It still is a metric, real matrix, so that's nice. So we know there's a full set of eigenvectors and real eigenvalues. But it's not, doesn't sum up to 1 anymore. So the rows and the columns don't sum up to 1 anymore. So the first eigenvector will not be the 1, 1, 1, 1 vector anymore. We can also go and see what objective function this would correspond to. So if you plug in U transpose U hat transpose L hat U hat, we find with the definition of L this one here, and then with the definition. So we simply replace our L hat matrix by D underscore L D underscore. Then we arrange things a little bit. Since D is a diagonal matrix, the transpose is the same as the matrix itself, which is why we can do this here. And then we use our equation 39 from above, which relates this Y transpose LY to this term where we have Y I minus YJ. And then if we now do this multiplication with this D matrix, we get this objective function, which is similar to the original one, except that the values of the nodes are divided by the square root of the degree matrix, whatever that means. So we see there's the generalized eigenvalue problem can be transformed into an ordinary one, which is maybe easier to deal with, or where one is more familiar with. And then with a mapping that we've defined up here, we can map sort of the one solution onto the other solution of the generalized eigenvalue problem.